This will be the last one. Was it the Capitol Hilton? I believe so.
Yeah, sounds good, Skip.
This is Chris Widmer doing a Skip Holmes imitation.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, President and Mrs. Reagan could come by and say hello to America's veterans and to those veterans who we honor this evening, the recipients of the Medal of Honor, the highest honor that our country can bestow on any veteran. Mr. President, it's all yours.
We have been visiting the other 10 inaugural balls that are being held, but this one is special. And you know, one of the reasons is this whole ceremony, the inauguration of a president, and everything else of this kind highlights some truths about our country, and that is how very rare in the world it is that the changes of government can occur in such an orderly way as they do in our country, with the freedom that we have, and the freedom to vote, and a constitution in which what is basically different from almost every other world in that our constitution does not say what the government will allow us to do, it says what we will allow the government to do. Because in this gathering, above all others, most of you here, it's because of you that we still have that system and those freedoms. And I know that tonight you are honoring some very special individuals, those who contributed above and beyond the call of duty, therefore received the Congressional Medal of Honor, the highest award that we can give in this land. And may I say directly to you, who are the recipients of that Congressional Medal of Honor, that your names are on an honor roll that is an honor roll of freedom itself. God bless all of you, and thank all of you very much.
From her, no one could ever replace.